Thank you for calling the Walt Disney World Resort. My name is Gibi. I'll be happy to help you today. May I please know who I have the pleasure of speaking with? Thank you. And in the event that we should become disconnected, may I please have a telephone number to call you back on? Wonderful. Thank you so much. Oh, this is typically when I would ask how I can help you today, but I think I may know why you're calling. Did you happen to enter our magical celebration sweepstakes? You did. Oh my goodness, and just to be extra sure that I have the right person, can you confirm your mailing address for me? Thank you. Oh my goodness. Well, I can tell you, a winner has been selected, and oh my gosh, I can't believe that I get to be the one to tell you this news, but you won. Yes, you won. Oh my gosh, congratulations. Oh, thank you so much for calling in. I have quite the vacation for you and your guests. If now is a good time, I would love to go over absolutely everything with you. Or maybe we can just settle on a few things here and there, and I can give you a bit of information depending on how much time you have. Fantastic. Well, if you just stay on the line, I need a few things from you to get your trip in motion, book your VIP experience, choose your resort. Yes! Oh, this is so exciting. I'll give you a moment, please. Okay. We will be sending all this information to your email as well, so don't worry about writing anything down. Are you ready? Okay. Well, you will start with a round trip first class air travel aboard Delta Airlines, including Sky Priority Security Screening, preferred boarding, expedited bagging service for up to 2 checked bags per passenger, and the top tier comfort and dedicated service of Delta's first class cabin. Then, once you arrive at the Orlando International Airport, you'll be met by your own private chauffeured transportation and taken directly to your resort hotel, which we can choose in just a moment. As for accommodations, of course, nothing but the best. You'll get your choice of any Walt Disney World's deluxe resort hotels, and of course, you'll be receiving 7-day Park Hopper Plus tickets, giving you full access to Magic Kingdom, Epcot, Disney's Hollywood Studios, and Disney's Animal Kingdom, as well as our 2 water parks. Yes, Typhoon Lagoon and Blizzard Beach. Oh my gosh, I am just so excited for you. Well, the travel, hotel, and park tickets, that's only the beginning. This is the full VIP experience that you've won here today. We are rolling out the red mouse ears. You will have a private VIP tour guide for each of your days in the park. They'll provide you with transportation from your resort hotel to all of your destinations, share insights and history about the parks, and perhaps most importantly, provide you with special access to attractions and entertainment. Put another way, you're going to get to skip all the lines. Yes, the guides at the guest relations are some of my favorite cast members at the whole resort. They are so knowledgeable, and everyone at Walt Disney World is courteous and helpful, but these guides are just above and beyond. You're going to have such a wonderful experience, no matter who you get. Okay. Oh my gosh. You and each of your guests will receive our deluxe dining pass, which can be used in the parks as well as the resort hotels. That includes 3 meals a day at your choice of table service or quick service dining locations. Some people choose to sit down, prefer to have a more restaurant dining experience, while other people are really grab and go, just ready to get to the next thing. But you'll be able to choose either. It also comes with 2 snacks or bottled beverages and a souvenir mug, and you can have that filled at a soft drink station at your resort hotel. Snacks, they can be found at outdoor locations in the park, and include items such as popsicles, fruits, popcorn, ice cream. The novelty Mickey Mouse ears ice cream is perfect. It's my favorite. Bagged chips, that sort of thing. And that voucher can also be used at buffet dining locations and for character dining experiences as well. Yes, it does also work with room service. You can even order in-room pizza. Yeah. Oh, another one of the things that's helpful when considering dining is that you can reserve your restaurant visits well in advance of your travel. We don't have to do that today, but it does help with the planning side. If you know where you want to eat and when, you can get those reservations done, and that way you can enjoy your full park experience without wondering where you're going to eat or trying to make reservations day of or day before. Yeah, it's a time saver that people don't usually think of, but it really adds up, you know. I mean, of course, you'll be having the VIP experience, so you won't be spending too much time waiting in line, so that's also a plus. I know, it's all so magical. Well, as I'm sure that you read in our sweepstakes, in order to cover any upgrades, incidentals, and souvenir shopping that you want to do, you will be receiving a $10,000 gift card. Yes, that is some serious pixie dust. Now that I've gone over all of that, and I know that was a lot of information at once, do you have some time to look at which resort hotel you might like to stay at? Absolutely. Let's look at the deluxe resorts, and perhaps we can just narrow down a few favorites. I'll give you an in-depth look at the specific room types and such. Does that seem like a useful approach? Fantastic. Well, let's begin then with one of the absolute crown jewels of Walt Disney World, the Grand Floridian Resort and Spa. Here's a description. Victorian elegance meets modern sophistication at this lavish Disney Resort hotel. Unwind outdoors, indulge in a luxurious massage, and watch evening fireworks light up the sky over Cinderella Castle. Just one stop to Magic Kingdom Park on the complimentary resort monorail, this timeless Victorian-style marvel evokes Palm Beach's golden era. Now, I personally have had the opportunity to tour most of the resort hotels on the property, and I just love this one. It is opulent without being stuffy. There's this beautiful Victorian hotel near San Diego that I visited once called the Hotel de Coronado. The Grand Floridian is like that. Well, if it had been designed by Mary Poppins. It's practically perfect in every way. Now, if you decide that this is where you'd like to stay, and honestly, even if you don't stay here, I do strongly recommend afternoon tea and the garden view tea room. So much of what we try to do for our guests is to make dreams come true, and this is the dream come true of anyone who has ever served imaginary tea with their stuffed animals. Oh, it's absolutely lovely. I think just beyond being a big, beautiful hotel, the location is a really strong point for the Grand Floridian. The view of Cinderella Castle from here is breathtaking. One of the things we say about staying on the property is that you're staying inside the magic. For me, that's even more true when there is a view of the parks or fireworks right from your room. So, what do you think? Is the Grand Floridian worth considering further? Oh, absolutely. I would definitely have this on my shortlist as well. All right. Up next is the Disney's Polynesian Village Resort. This is another property that's situated on Seven Seas Lagoon. And in the case of both the Grand Floridian, you'll have easy access by monorail right to the entrance of Magic Kingdom. But you'll also be able to get there using these charming boats called water taxis. Mm-hmm. Either or. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's how I think about it as well. That's the experience that we love at the parks. Yeah, it follows you right to your hotel room. You can hop on a boat or a monorail or the Skyliner to get around. Entertainment options are right there at your resort hotel. All of the fun of Disney's dining experiences, that's all right there. Dreams do begin coming true as soon as you're on the property, and the magic just keeps coming. So, as we were discussing, the Polynesian is on the Seven Seas Lagoon. It's a little further from the Magic Kingdom than the Grand Floridian is, but you can still see the castle and fireworks. And I can read you the description. Celebrate the spirit of the South Pacific at this oasis of tropical palms, lush vegetation, and so much more. From moonlit nights immersed in the outdoor island ambiance to the exotic tastes of our world-class restaurants, discover the signature tropical atmosphere that's made Disney's Polynesian Village Resort a favorite Disney destination since 1971. The Polynesian is another one of my favorites. The Ohana breakfast is absolutely something I always recommend to parties traveling with children. But honestly, even as an adult, I had so much fun having breakfast with Lilo and Stitch. Maybe I'm biased, but it just made me so happy. Oh, another point, if you're considering the Polynesian, is that they have these amazing bungalows out on the water. They're equipped much more like a little house. They have kitchens, washers, dryers. Right. Yes, a home away from home, but it's out over the lagoon with a view of the fireworks. Definitely best of both worlds. So should we keep that in mind? Sure, and the bungalow in particular? Absolutely. Well then let's just kind of stay with that geographic area and then we can talk about Disney's contemporary resort then. Okay. Perfect. So, where the Grand Floridian has this lovely view of Cinderella's castle over the lagoon, and then the Polynesian has the amazing bungalows, the Contemporary is the resort if you're looking for the best view of the fireworks. In particular, the California Grill features a special dining and fireworks experience. Oh, it's just a wonderful way to mark the occasion. The other feature that is unique to Disney's Contemporary Resort is that it's built around a monorail system. The monorail travels right through the middle of the building. I can read you the description. Retreat to this ultra-modern Disney Resort Hotel and discover award-winning dining, spectacular views, and dazzling pools. Whether you're staying in the iconic A-frame contemporary tower or the nearby garden wing, you can walk to Magic Kingdom Main Gate or catch the resort monorail as it breezes through the tower. Inside, a 90-foot-tall mural by Disney legend Mary Blair, responsible for the distinct look and feel of the It's a Small World attraction, celebrates the Grand Canyon and the American Southwest. Yes, I love that they talk about Mary Blair here. She was such a pioneer, a visionary woman in a role mostly given to men. Well, if you notice as you walk down Main Street in the Magic Kingdom, there are tributes to Disney legends painted in the windows, and Mary Blair has a window dedicated to her in honor of her contributions. Anyway, back on track. How does the contemporary sound? Yeah, it's definitely a little more clean, modern. Okay, sure. Yeah, okay. Well, perhaps our next choice will be more your style then. Disney's Fort Wilderness Lodge. Oh, guests love this property. I love this property. This is true of Polynesian Village also, but when you're at Fort Wilderness Lodge, it just completely transports you. Oh, yes, you're in the middle of a whole bunch of theme parks, but then you get to the property and it's like the entire world just transforms and you're at a national park. I'll read you the description. Escape to the rustic majesty of America's Great Northwest. Inspired by turn-of-the-century national park lodges, Disney's Wilderness Lodge celebrates American craftsmanship and honors the beauty of the untamed wilderness. Soak in the splendor of the great outdoors, from nature trails through pine forests to rocking chairs that overlook a murmuring creek. Inside, discover towering totem poles, headdresses, and more, and enjoy the rustic elegance of the stone hearth and roaring fireplace. It's such a beautiful hotel. If you're more familiar with our Anaheim properties, I'm not sure where you're located, but the Fort Wilderness gives me some of the same feel as the Grand Californian. Yeah, like the scale is grand, but it also feels completely one with nature. This might also be one of my favorite pools at the resorts. Oh, here again, it's about this wonderful feel of nature. It's magical like the parks, but in an entirely different way. It's like getting a bonus vacation to Yellowstone or the Great Smoky Mountains or Yosemite. Okay, big yes there. Okay, well, if you liked Fort Wilderness, I think you might like this one too. Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge. Oh, this is one of my favorites. I think the amenities at each of the resorts are amazing and unique, but this one has a feature that none of the rest have. Animals. There are literally giraffes outside your window. Tall, gorgeous, non-animatronic giraffes. Let me pull up the description here. Okay. Step into the heart of Africa at this magnificent resort hotel. Inspired by the traditional African crawl, the horseshoe curve design provides spectacular views of four lush savannas that over 200 hoofed animals and birds call home. Delight in dazzling pool areas, exciting animal programs, and one of the largest collections of African art in the United States as you experience your own African safari adventure with a touch of Disney magic. So it's sort of that same feeling with the Polynesian Village and Fort Wilderness. You just get completely transported into another place at this resort. This is also where you'll find my favorite dining experience, Dine with an Animal Specialist. Oh, it's awesome. Does this sound like the winner? I had you at giraffes? Okay, okay. I think that is a great choice. I just adore this property. Should we look at the room options then? Wonderful. Wonderful. Well, if we are going with the Animal Kingdom Lodge, let me just... I have something that I want to check out just in case with your dates. And that would be... Okay, perfect. I think I have the obvious choice available. I can get you the Royal Asante Suite. It's our presidential suite. Oh, it features these amazing, expansive savannah views, and oh, it's just absolutely everything a sweepstakes winner deserves, right from the door. Or in this case, the double doors. Well, when you first enter, you're in a sort of cylinder-shaped entry, and there's amazing lighting and these little recesses along the walls with sculptures in them. And oh, I got to go tour this suite, and words cannot describe how beautiful this space is. There is a polished wood slab dining table. The shower is inlaid with these little decorative pebbles. Oh, it's beautiful. Yes. Oh, let me look up the size of this suite. I know it's huge. Over 2,100 square feet. Absolutely. You're going to feel like Disney royalty. So, I talked about the entry, the dining table, which seats up to 8 guests. The central living space is another round room with a fireplace and big windows and a domed ceiling with curved beams. Sort of a thatched look. Oh, stunning. Almost a modern take on a hut. There's a canopy bed made from tree branches, a freestanding tub in one of the bathrooms, as well as a walk-in rainfall shower for two. It has an office, full kitchen, two bedrooms, two bathrooms, living room, dining room. But most importantly, it has a huge balcony. Yes, you can sit and watch all of the animals right from your space. Oh, I think you've made the perfect choice. It's Disney, and yet it's a world away. Yeah, you get the best of both. So that date range, that works for your travel. I just want to lock that in right now. Okay, perfect. Should I go ahead and make those room reservations? Okay. They're yours. Easy as that. So, from this point, now that we have the details figured out, the main parts are already done. You'll be working with myself as well as cast members from around the resort to get absolutely all the little details just right for your trip. I will be available for making travel arrangements, meal and show reservations, all those sorts of things. And I, too, will put you in touch with guest relations, who will be happy to talk to you about tours and theme park experiences. Of course, if you have any questions or things we can help you with, I will remain your primary point of contact for the whole scope of the trip planning. If I don't have an answer, I will get one for you from a cast member with that knowledge. Okay. Well, let me just say again then, congratulations. This is going to be a memory that you can cherish forever. I'm honored to have shared it with you. You certainly wished upon the right star. I will be so very excited to get further into your planning in the future. It's been my pleasure. I'll send those emails in the next few minutes with the details as they stand so far. And I will get your information to my colleagues so that we can all coordinate the details with you. I and make your stay just absolutely as magical as possible. I'm so glad that I got to speak with you today. Is there absolutely anything else I can do to help right now? Well, congratulations again. Thank you for calling the Walt Disney World Resort, and have a magical day.